I hear music and there's no one there. I smell blossoms and the trees are bare. All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why, I wonder why. I keep tossing in my sleep at night, and what's more, I've lost my appetite. Stars that used to twinkle in the sky are twinkling in my eyes. I wonder why. Tell me why, Faye. You don't need analyzing, and it's not so surprising that you feel just the way you do. Your heart goes pitter-patter. How just, what's the matter? Because I've been there once or twice. So put your little head on my shoulder. You need someone that's older, or rubbed down with a velvet glove. Now there is nothing you can take to relieve that pleasant ache. You're not sick, Jeannie, you're just in love.
I hear music and there's no one there. I smell blossoms and the trees are bare. All day long I seem to wonder, I wonder why.
Because I've been there,
I wonder why.
Drifting on, floating weightless, across the stratosphere. The final message, give my far beneath the ship, the world is mourning. They don't realize he's alive. No one understands, but Major Tom sees now the light commands. This is my home. I'm coming home. 4, 3, 2, 1.
If you want to be with someone, why not be with me? If you want to be with someone, why can't it be me? It's crazy, crazy, I'm in love with you. You're the only one I ever knew. If you want to talk to someone, why not talk to me? If you want to talk to someone, why can't it be me? It's crazy, crazy, I'm in love with you. You're the only one I ever knew.
high school, I sat in the back row and I thought to myself, this is really for shit. I just couldn't wait to get out and do something on my own. So I quit school and went out to look for a job. First I waited on tables, then I worked at Woolworths, and then I emptied bedpans in a hospital. But no matter where I worked, it was all the same. And I got so I just couldn't take it anymore. Well, one day I went home and I found my mom sitting there. She'd been fired by the phone company because they said she was too old. And I saw a book in her lap and I asked her what it was. She said, baby, that's Capital, Volume 1. You know, by Karl Marx. And I said, huh? And she said, that's right, here, take a look. And I read that book, and now I've come to realize that as long as I have to sell my labor power to the boss, I work for his profit and not for myself or my fellow humankind.
Understanding Marx will straighten out your head. More than anything that you have read.
Boys of thought and Skinner's of no use.
Read Marx and Lenin, it will really turn you loose.
You know, I had me a nice looking job, and it paid pretty good, you know? And I got myself a swimming pool, a wide-track Pontiac, even a snowmobile, one of the Jap makes. But the more I spent, the more I'd end up owing, and I had to work overtime at the goddamn job. Well, I'm in the locker room one night after the shift, and the janitor comes in and he says, fellow worker, you look mighty unhappy. And I said, huh? He said, read this, and he gives me a book. So I said, what's this? And he says, it's State and Revolution. It's by Lenin. Well, I'm not a man who reads many books, but I read that book, and now I know that as long as you sell yourself, you cannot be yourself, and you cannot snowmobile your way down the forest trail to inner peace.
I graduated magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, and I thought I had a responsibility to help out people who didn't know how to help themselves. So I went into the Peace Corps, and I taught Nigerians how to fix cars and run hotels. Then I came back home and went to D.C. I doled out money for minority businesses, you know, black capitalism. Well, one day some congressman came to see one of my best projects, and I couldn't believe my eyes. The workers were on strike! So I said, what's going on here? And they said, prices are high, wages are low, and working conditions are terrible. And I said, but you're working for one of your own kind. And they answered, he's not one of us. Here, read this. It was a little book called On the Correct Handling of Contradictions Among the People by Mao Zedong. I've read a lot of books. When I read that book, well, now I understand that the only way to bring about social change is to organize a united mass movement based on the class interests of the proletariat.
Understanding Marx will straighten out your head.
So great, real finger licking, and no one can debate that all of the family will love it just like you. Kentucky Fried Chicken is waiting there for you. If you love your pussies, do as others do. Go see the Colonel and buy a barrel too.
best fried chicken in the USA. Kentucky Fried Chicken is really here to stay. Kentucky Fried Chicken is really here to stay. Kentucky Fried Chicken is really here to stay.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Elvis Presley. I'm here to entertain you with Casio's karaoke machine. This is our new $129. You two can sing along with the king, because everybody's got a little bit of the king in them. And the king says he wants you to sing. He wants you to sing like the king. Uh-huh. Now get your leg going, too, now. Uh-huh. Get your lip, too. Uh-huh. All right, people. I'm going to be doing some tunes for it, and I got some special Elvis memento, so you can all remember that you saw the king here in Chicago at the Casio karaoke booth. All right, thank you.
I walked through a party at the county jail. Prison band was there and they began to wail. Band was early born. Joint began to jump. My whole rhythm section was a purple gang. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the wholesale block was dancing to the jailhouse rock. Spider Murphy played on the saxophone. Little Joe was blowing on the slide trombone. A drummer Bob Millen on the crash boom bang. Could have heard them knocked out jailbird sing. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the wholesale block was dancing to the jailhouse rock. Number 47 said to number 3, are you the cutest jailbird I ever did see? Sure will be delighted with your company. Come and do the jailhouse rock with me. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the wholesale block was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
Let's rock it, kids.
I got some Elvis mementos here. You can remember your visit with Elvis. Here you go, sir. All right, thank you. There you go, a little memento with Elvis.
A sad sack was sitting on a block of stone. Over in the corner sitting all alone. Wasn't said about it, don't you be no square. You can't find a partner, use a wooden chair. That's right. Everybody get your Elvis memento. Everybody get yourself away. Yeah, Elvis way.
We got special Elvis gifts here, Elvis presents. You get your own Elvis present here, I'm giving them out for you. All right. Did you get your Elvis gift, sir? There you go, get your Elvis gift. Get your Elvis gift. Everybody want an Elvis gift here. I think everybody does want an Elvis gift. I know I want to give out an Elvis gift.
You know, you can find me standing on the Casio booth. It's been such a long time since I've been dead. You know, it feels really good. To be here, singing for you. Baby, don't make me mad. Don't walk away. Stand over here and listen to me. Give you a serenade. Don't make me to a heart that's true. I'm all alone. Baby, it's just you. Come on over here and love me. You know I want you. because I really love you, baby, bless my heart. So walk to the preacher, baby, say I do. Then you'll know you have me, and I know that I'll have you. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no one I love, baby, it's just you. All you can ask, don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't want no other love, baby, it's just you. I'll make it up.
All right, thank you, people. Thank you. The Kinks gonna take a little break now. Just a little break.
My heart was a baby, loving teddy bear. I put a chain around my body, lead me anywhere. Cause you know I love computers and stuff. See a tiger, tigers play too rough. I don't like to stick my fingers in light sockets cause they hurt. Just wanna be a computer geek. I trip over my toes and they let me be your teddy bear. Let me be around you all night. Run your fingers through my hair and cuddle me real tight. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. I don't wanna be a tiger. Tigers play too rough. I don't wanna be a lion. Lions ain't the kind you're loving of. I just wanna be your teddy bear. I put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. Just wanna be your teddy bear.
All right, thank you very much. Now, this is the Casio karaoke system here. You just put a tape in here and you can sing along with it. You can sing with the king because that's what we're all really have inside of us. We have the king inside of us. The king is here with us tonight. And I want y'all to realize that. If anybody wants to come up here and sing with me, I'll be delighted because we all have Elvis in us. I want y'all to feel Elvis inside of you. I want to hear him. And then Elvis is saying to you, he wants you to sing. He wants you to sing like the king. Now, he wants you to hear you go, uh-huh, uh-huh. You want to get that leg going out too. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Get your lip now. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Anybody want to come up here and sing with me? I got all kinds of music here you can all sing with. I'll be happy and delighted to cue it up for you and have it all set up. You too can sound like the king. All right, people. Not too many takers here, but I got a few gifts here left over. I got a few things here I can give to people. Here, a little treasure from Elvis. All right, nice catch. Anybody can sing. Anybody can sing like the king. Because the king is with us. The king is universal. The king is it.
Ooh, oui.
Alors, Mme Saint-Onge, les voix sont prêtes, alors on commence, c'est ça?
Oui, c'est prêt.
Okay, alors, on commence.
Attention, on y va.
Attention. Il m'a quitté, à qui j'ai tout donné, il me fait pleurer. Je sais qu'il aime une autre fille.
An army towel covering my belly. Some of us weep, some of us howl, knees turn to jelly. But next, I was just a child, 100 like me. I followed a naked body followed me. Next. A child when my innocence was lost in a mobile army whorehouse, a gift of the army, free of cost. Next. Me, I really would have liked a little bit of tenderness, maybe a word, maybe a smile, maybe some happiness. But next. Oh, it was not so tragic, and heaven did not fall. But how much at that time I hated being there at all. Next. I still recall the brothel trucks, the flying flags, the queer lieutenant who slapped our asses thinking we were fags. Next. I swear on the wet head of my first case of gonorrhea, it is his ugly voice that I forever fear, saying, next. A voice that speaks of whiskey, of corpses, and of mud. The voice of nations, the thick voice of blood. Next. Since then, each woman I have taken into bed, they seem to lie in my arms and whisper in my head. They whisper, next. Oh, the naked and the dead could hold each other's hands as they watch me dream at night in a dream that no one understands. And though I am not dreaming in a voice grown dry and hollow, stand on endless naked lines of the following and the followed. Next. One day I'll cut my legs off. I'll burn myself alive. I'll do anything to get out of life, to survive. Not ever to be next. Next. Not ever to be next. Next. Not ever to be next. Next.
somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why, oh, why can't I? At one time or another in our lives, everyone asks themselves questions. Why? We, the juniors of Canarsie High School, were born into a world where we have only known war, corruption in our government, racial problems in our country, pollution in our air and waters, and above all, a great distrust among the generations. That land, the land that we dream of, the land over the rainbow, could be our land. But we must work for it, all of us, to make our nation the greatest possible nation, the nation that it really should be. We, the juniors of Canarsie High School, know our responsibility and our obligation, and we accept the challenge. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Fly over the rainbow. Why, oh, why can't I? And now, ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the junior alma mater.
For those of you who might have just joined us late in the broadcast, we're talking with Michael Mills, Minister of Youth and Evangelism at the Family Altar Chapel in Battle Creek, Michigan. Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven, again, was voted the most popular tune of rock's history. Keep that in mind as I share this taped excerpt with you. In the lyrics of the song, they sing, "The Piper is calling you to join him. She's buying her stairway to heaven." We know that's not possible. And also they say, words have two meanings. They certainly do have two meanings. This is where the subliminal message comes in that we've been talking about in the previous interview. The subliminal message is a satanic message that was put on their record, Stairway to Heaven, in reverse. And what I mean by in reverse is by taking the record, putting it in a neutral position, and spinning the record backwards. The needle will go in the opposite direction. You say that, I've never heard of anything like that before. Probably not, but many, many people have. And this is where I'm talking about that I believe that we can hear this with our subconscious mind, and you're going to hear it in a few moments. I want to explain to you what their message is. Now, we spun this backwards in a studio, and the tape of what we've got is about to come up. They sing backwards in human voices. Now, mind you, it made sense on both sides. It wasn't a bunch of garble on one side and played it in reverse and it made sense. It made sense on both sides. They sang in human voices in reverse, "Listen, we've been there." Then they sing in reverse now, "Because I live." "Serve me." "There's no escaping it." "Satan."
If we
"Gotta live for Satan."
"Gotta live for Satan."
"Master Satan."
"Master Satan."
The message that they have all together that they wanted you to hear in a subliminal way on the back or in reverse of Stairway to Heaven was this: "Listen, we've been there. Because I live, serve me. There's no escape in it. Satan. If we gotta live for Satan, Master Satan." Listen to it as they sing their message together. Further in the tape, I came across another part that made me throw my headphones right off my head. I couldn't believe what I heard. I kept thinking about the verse that describes hell in the Bible as a wailing and a gnashing of teeth. And that came to my mind when I heard this next sound, and is opposite of the instrumental part in the prelude of Stairway to Heaven. Listen to this as it reminds you of the verse, a wailing and a gnashing of teeth. Again, another rock group who is tied definitely in with the occult. They had a definite message to give, who they are serving through their music. Kiss, or sometimes known or referred to as Kings in Satanic service. With sadomasochistic chains and demonic painted faces, they jump on stage, some wearing crosses, puking blood, singing, "God of Rock and Roll will steal your virgin soul." Maybe the virgin souls they are referring to are the 8 and 9 year olds that they have comic books directed to in which they are referred to as demons. The paraphernalia that are available to kids in regards to Kiss includes jeans, dolls, Halloween costumes, eyeshadow, shampoo, soap, cologne, necklaces, hats, belt buckles, and it's endless. The gross for 1 year of paraphernalia for Kiss products is $117 million. One rock magazine calls them fire-breathing demons from rock and roll hell. Their comic book editor said this of the children's obsession with Kiss, and I quote, "At first parents' reaction will be total revulsion. Then they'll just shake their heads in dismay and go back to watching TV. Don't be that way, Christian parent. Kiss had a television special which featured the groups exhibiting psychic phenomena, enlarging their boundaries of power to the supernatural. And this was directed to the children. Ex-Kiss drummer Peter Criss said this. He boldly declared, "I find myself evil. I believe in the devil as much as God. You can use either one to get things done." Gene Simmons, one of the singers of the group, who is known for his extended serpent-like tongue, which incidentally is an ancient pagan symbol for demonic worship, said, and I quote again, "If God is hot stuff, why is he afraid to have other gods before him? I've always wanted to be God." He was also known of boasting to People magazine of sleeping with 1,000 women. A Detroit rock promoter said this of Kiss in Circus magazine, "It's almost like a Hitler rock, because that audience, because of their beat, they're mesmerized by the music. They have that audience hypnotized." Recently, a teenage Christian girl came to me complaining of her room turning almost a eerie and a deathly cold. She's been having other things strange happening to her. I asked her at that time what type of music she was listening to, and she said she was totally obsessed with Kiss. And I said, "How obsessed?" She said she had 14 albums of Kiss in her room, a 6-foot poster of the group in her room. She says, "It's getting to the point where I can't go to sleep without listening to them as I fall asleep." She says, "I can't even do my homework. I know my parents are worried about me." She turned her life, turned her music over to Jesus Christ. Since then, she's had total freedom. She burned those records, and she hasn't had a problem like that since. Kiss is also known for their repetitious heavy metal sound, a repetitious hypnotic beat. With that in mind, I want to share with you another tape excerpt from the Beatles' Revolution No. 9, as they repetitiously repeat number 9, number 9, number 9.
Number 9.
We reversed that number 9 because it seemed that there would be a message there, and there was. The Beatles had a message for you to hear in their Revolution No. 9. Opposite of that, they say, "Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man.
Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man. Turn me on, dead man.
From the Beatles' Revolution No. 9. A drag term on the street for homosexual is Queen. The music group Queen has a message for you. In their album Night at the Opera, they sing Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. In their hit Another One Bites the Dust, their hidden message, in reverse, is some of us smoke marijuana. Listen to this tape excerpt. As I also note, the second time through, I left the tape on so you could hear through finger control me move the record frontwards and reverse for the message, some of us smoke marijuana.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. Ow! Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey! Another one bites the dust. Hey, 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 hey.
You have heard of group after group who worshipfully sing for Satan. They know he is real. God tells us he's not willing that any should perish. And that includes Mick Jagger and Alice Cooper and all of the rock singers. But they have a choice to make. What about you? What do you choose?
Thank you.
season now is cold and white, and all the trees are bare. The grass is brown and flowers down, but I don't seem to care. 'Cause even though my toes get tight when I walk to the store, I know there's heat for my poor feet, and cold means even more.
Ever notice how fresh and clean and wonderful cold can be when you're going home? Chromalox creates the kind of warm that helps you love cold. It's a smooth, quiet, toasty warm that brings the season to life.
The grass grows tall, and good smells fill the land. And even though I sneeze a lot, I really shouldn't care. I'll just decide to go inside to where there's cleaner air.
Spring, rain, cool days and warm days. Days that, once in a while, still drive you indoors to the comfort of Chromalox. Heating, cooling, cleaning the air. Chromalox devotes its products to making it a happier spring.
happy time. The days are full of fun. The trees are full of lazy leaves. The sky is full of sun. Summer is a happy time. We love the sun a lot. But getting cool is happy too when summer gets too hot.
The summer sun. Remember all the times it made you hot, really hot, and you almost enjoyed it because you knew you'd soon be cool. That's the Chromalox double season of summer. Warm is beautiful when you know there's cold. Fragrant air is beautiful when you know there's filtered air. Summer is beautiful when you know there's Chromalox.
Autumn never stays the same. It's either rain or shine. And I look through my window pane and watch her change her mind.
Pretty strange this autumn season. One day warm and cheerful, the next cold and dreary. Usually kind of uncomfortable indoors. But Chromalox has the answer. Products that cool and heat and clean and filter, all making our work more productive, our play more enjoyable, our autumn happier and healthier. Are the Chromalox seasons, colorfully joined by nature, methodically linked by the finest line of comfort products in the world. Good products, reliable products, products that visibly reflect the Chromalox concern for all the factors that make man happy.
Must have been cold. sunlight on your face. You've been content to let me shine. You always walked a step
picking girls up in a women's clothing store is one of the boldest pickups because you go straight to where the girls are. The smartest guys use the prince who is all thumbs approach, charming but simultaneously a little helpless. After all, a prince knows how to shop for his own clothes, but when it comes to getting a gift for his sister or aunt in a women's department, he needs a little help. And girls love to help a just slightly helpless prince. It gives them a good feeling about themselves, because it's a woman's instinct to help a man and make him happy, whether it's shopping or, as you know, in bed. In Boston, Frank really hit the jackpot. Frank himself had put on some sharp sport clothes, because you can't operate in a clothing store looking like a bum, since the girls in stores are all very clothes conscious. Listen how Frank, a prince who's all thumbs, takes his time, letting his natural friendliness and sincerity do the trick for him.
Excuse me, but I need a little help.
I'm sorry, I don't work here.
Oh, I could tell that by the way you dress, but that's why I think you could really help me.
I think you really need a salesperson. There's one right over there.
Now, this chick isn't making it easy for Frank, but he plays it slow and easy. He hasn't even thrown her the bait yet. Now he turns on some of the prince's charm.
But that sales lady obviously doesn't have your good taste. I can tell that by the way you're dressed. If she helps me pick out a birthday present for my sister will hate it.
Oh, you're getting a present for your sister?
Suddenly, a little interest from the chick. Like any girl, she loves presents. Most girls even like to pick them out for people they don't even know. And this girl is no exception.
Yeah, it's my sister's 21st birthday, and I want to get her something just right. But she has the same look you do. You know, the same nice figure, the same dramatic-looking, classy clothes.
Oh, thank you.
But when I look at these blouses on the rack, I can't imagine what they'd look like on her.
It does take some practice to be able to tell.
Now she's warming up a little to our prince. She's sympathetic. He's alternating charm with being all thumbs, and the combination seems to be working. Listen.
What size is your sister?
That's another thing. I'm not really sure. Wait! She's about your size, maybe an inch shorter. What size do you wear?
An 8, but these blouses are all small, medium, and large, so she's probably a medium, like me.
Oh, brother, I'll never find what I need. Even if I get the right size, how will I know what it'll look like on her? I really want to get her something nice, too. It's such a special day for her.
Well, I'm sure you'll find something.
Frank realizes he has to turn on a little more charm, or this college chick isn't going to help him. He's been playing things a little too helpless, so he throws her a timely compliment.
I know. I'll just get her a blouse like the one you have on. It looks terrific and it fits so well. My sister has the same kind of courage you do. That blouse will look almost as good on her as it does on you. Did you get it here?
This? This is just an old rag.
Old rag, my foot. It's a knockout. Where can I get one?
Well, you can't now. It's from last season.
Then what am I going to do?
Now Frank's at the crucial point, but his timing has been nearly flawless. He hasn't pushed, but he set her up with those compliments about her figure, and she's warmed up to him. He remembers that girls can't resist being helpful. Listen to how he handles it.
Say, if I pick out a couple of blouses I like, would you try them on and then I can see how they look? Oh, we'll only take a minute and I could choose the right one for my sister.
Well, I was 21 myself a month ago. I know how important that birthday is.
Only 21. You look much older, more sophisticated than my sister. Would you try these two?
Okay, why not? I'd like to help. I'll change in the dressing room and be right back.
Of course, this chick has no way of knowing that Frank's just picked out the two sexiest blouses, and he's not thinking about anybody's sister anymore. In fact, Frank hasn't even got a sister. First, the chick comes out in the skin-tight print blouse. Frank stays calm and pretends to study the look of the blouse. Then she goes back into the dressing room to change into the second blouse, a see-through. When she comes out this time, she's not wearing a bra. Frank can't believe it.
That's the one. That's a terrific-looking blouse. You look terrific in it. You've got a dynamite figure.
Well, thank you. You really make me feel pretty.
Hear that? She says he makes her feel pretty. And it's true. Girls like to be told they're pretty, even if they already know it. She likes Frank because he notices her good points and compliments her. While she changes back into her own clothes, he buys the blouse. Then he makes his pitch for a date.
I'm really grateful for your help. I never could have found the right one without you.
I enjoyed helping you. Your sister's lucky to have such a thoughtful brother.
Say, I'd like to thank you somehow. How about joining me for a quick drink across the street?
Well, I haven't found a blouse for myself yet.
Well, we'll just have a quick one, then we'll come right back.
Okay, that'd be nice.
But Frank has more in mind for this swinger than just a drink.
Thanks for the drink, Frank. I've enjoyed talking, but now I've got to get back before the store closes and get my own blouse.
You've already got it.
What do you mean?
This one. The one I bought. It's yours. I bought it for you because you look so great, man.
But, well, what about your sister's present?
I'll get another one for her tomorrow. Maybe you can help. But now, wouldn't you like to have some dinner?
Oh, wow! You're some operator. I'd love to have dinner with you.
He did it. She's delighted with the blouse and impressed with Frank's technique. He really surprised her there at the end, but now she has an even better surprise for him.
Before we eat, though, I want to visit the ladies' room and put on my new blouse. For you, Frank.
So what are you doing sitting home listening to this record when you could be scoring like Frank at your local department store? Try being a prince who's all thumbs. Your princess is just waiting.
A tribute to the music of the Beatles, presenting The Beatles Forever. I think the greatest reason for the classic quality of the Beatles' music is that they were constantly experimenting, striving for change. Each song brought new growth, new meaning. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for sharing this hour with us. And on behalf of Diane Carroll, Ray Charles, Anthony Dowell, Anthony Newley, Bernadette Peters, Mel Tillis, Paul Williams, and myself, Tony Randall, we'd like to thank George Harrison, John Lennon, Paul McCartney, and Ringo Starr, not only for their music, but for an era. The 60s, the age of Aquarius. Thank you, Beatles.
The clouds are heavy, the sky gets darker, and pretty soon there's going to be a storm. You like to go out to take a walk, but you don't want to take the train. Now the storm has come with thunder, and it seems the world is ending. People scatter here and there, but you're safe and well protected. Can always come back. You know that life is made of ups and downs. You want to be safe without a worry about the others getting cold. Now the rain is really pouring, and you're home without a worry. You don't think you could be sharing all your comfort with the others. You watch and wait, that's all you do. As if the world belonged to you.
Let us make a record for my Lord. Let us make a record for my Lord. Come on, let's make a record for my Lord. Let's make a record for my Lord. Prophet Isaiah made a record for my Lord. Prophet Isaiah made a record for my Lord. Ezekiel made a record for my Lord. Ezekiel made a record for my Lord. Cause let's make a record for my Lord. Let's make a record for my Lord. I want to make a record for my Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, let's make a record. I want to make a record for my Lord. Make a record for my Lord. I want to make a record for my Lord. Don't you want to make a record for my Lord? Don't you want to make a record for my Lord? Holy, 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 my God. Come on, let's make a record. Give up the world. Give up Lucifer. He's no good, a demon, a lying one. Let's make a record for my Lord. Come on, let's make a record for my Lord. He done made a record for my Lord. He done made a record for my Lord. I said, he done made a record for my Lord. He done made a record for my Lord. Don't you want to make a record for my Lord? Don't you want to make a record for my Lord? Well, I'm going to make a record for my Lord. I'm going to make a record for my Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hey, Lord, Lord. I want to make a record for my Lord. Wanna make a record for my Lord. Come on, let's make a record for my Lord. Let's make a record for my Lord. Praise him, praise him, praise him, hallelujah. Praise him, praise him.
I like cheese. Say, I like cheese, Christy.
I like cheese.
More, more, more.
I like cheese.
Say it more, more, more.
I like cheese.
More, more, more.
Say, I like cheese.
Say, I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese.
I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. I like cheese. Say more. I like cheese. I like this cheese. Beat that batter to mix your nene. I like cheese, do you know? Say, I like cheese, Christy.
I like cheese.
One more, more. Say it more times.
I like cheese.
Say it more times. I like cheese. Say, I like cheese. 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 I like cheese.
I like cheese.
I like cheese.
Love, dee da 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 da
Utica Club's the name, and this old town ain't never gonna be the same. got a secret I'll never tell. Don't try to ask, I'm under a spell. It's something that's happy, makes me laugh when I'm all alone. Maybe some people think I'm merely a fool. What kind of secret makes me drool? It's found under bushes, in the city, or even the woods. Maybe if your mind could wander far enough away, you might find my little secret in your everyday. If you don't know, just look in my eyes. They kind of sparkle like a surprise. It's not hard to figure. Take a wild guess and maybe you'll see. 'Cause maybe it's... Or maybe it's... Or maybe it's love.
Thank you. Looks like it'll be a while. Doctor's waiting room is packed. Guess I'll read a magazine. How to be an efficient executive. Have to read that sometime. Oh, what a car. And there's a beautiful girl leaning all over it. New kind of paint. Be great not to have to paint the house every other year. And there's a beautiful girl holding a paintbrush. A vacation trip to Hawaii. And there's a beautiful girl holding a ticket. You can sure see what draws a guy to look at these ads. Nothing man has made, God made girls. Of course, man has given them the big sex symbol image, but God made the initial form. Quite a design. Have to think about that the next time I'm watching a girl. Not to take the fun out of it. It'll just make girl watching mean more. You know? There she goes. High boots. Hipster miniskirt. Brief. Very brief. She's neat. Petite. Adds up to swinging gear. Wild. I think she likes to be watched, and everybody's watching. There's something special about her. She's got an image. Check the face. Lipstick gleams. It's creamy. Eyes couldn't be much bigger. Hair, long, straight, shiny, kind of glows. Looks like she's ready for a happening. Watch that girl. And check this out. They say God created people in the beginning of things. Girls included. Quite a design. God made it. You might think about that the next time you're watching a girl. Not to take the fun out of it. Just makes girl watching mean more.
Pearl Mesa, it is too. Comuni manana, David Arnold. Come on to San Risa, it is too. I see, it is too. Te dare speranza. It is too. Como you be a fresca in this manos. Come on a Fabrice, it is too, I see, it is too. Well, I want me.
Fuente et es tu el fuego de your God, et es tu como el fuego en el Gaia, et es tu el chico de mi pan. Como el poema, et es tu, et es tu. Come on, a guitarra in la noche. Come on, a horizonte, it is too, it is too. I see, it is too. It is too. Come well, agua. Mi fuente et es tu el fuego de llegar, et es tu como el fuego en mi hogueira, et es tu el chico de mi pan.
Sing along with Mary Kay. Some wise person said, act enthusiastic and you will become enthusiastic. The very act of singing stirs enthusiasm. We suggest that you learn these enthusiastic little ditties written by enthused Mary Kay consultants and sung for you by our company cheerleaders, the Vickaroos, and I am their leader, Sue Vickers. When you are feeling low or have a show, sing. Your spirits will rise, and you'll arrive at your show feeling enthusiastic in spite of yourself. One consultant tells us she gets up every morning and gets herself in the mood for her business day by playing the sing-along record. Try it. We begin all of our sales meetings by singing a couple of the Mary Kay songs. It sets the pace for a positive thinking meeting and builds esprit de corps among the unit members. This is the purpose of the sing-along record. Are you ready? Sing along now with the Vickaroos.
Everything looks brighter 'cause I'm to stay. Deep in the heart of Texas, all women cheer. You started here. Deep in the heart of Texas, for prettier skin, it's time to begin. With Mary Kay of Texas, take this tip from me. Try it and see. Our Mary Kay of Texas, there's a pack and a cream to make your skin gleam. From Mary Kay of Texas, there's makeup too, especially for you. From Mary Kay of Texas, all gals far and near will stand and cheer. For Mary Kay of Texas, need cash you say, now here's the way. Sell Mary Kay of Texas. All the way through the USA. With Mary Kay of Texas.
It's knowing that their doors will always open when we come to do a show. That makes me want to give my friends that extra special Mary Kay glow. Knowing that they'll thank me for that beauty they have tried so hard to find. That keeps my conscience clear at night, knowing I have done them right. It keeps me ever gentle on their minds. It's not that old idea that beauty fades because it's nature's way that finds me. It was nature's law of beauty that made Mary Kay the one to set me free. This freedom I can offer you, freedom from the ravages of time. That keeps my conscience clear at night, knowing I have done you right. It keeps me ever gentle on your mind. It keeps me ever gentle on your mind.
Next, we're going to have something unusual, rather. It comes from the Rod Stewart hit entitled, Do You Think I'm Sexy? Let's give a warm welcome for Brother Mark Savage.
Can I hear y'all now? Ah, can y'all feel it?
Come on, sugar, let me know. If you really need me, just come on, honey, tell me so.
Come on now.
natural home. Relax, baby, now we're all alone. I hear your whisper, come on.
This is the city, Los Angeles, California. There's a place here called Hollywood. People come here to see stars or be stars. Things can get pretty kinky here. That's when I go to work. My name's Thursday. I carry a badge. It was Friday. I was working the night watch downtown when the call came in from a popular rock nightclub. There was trouble at Madame Dong's.
Wait, bummer, dudes.
The place is packed.
What will we do?
Come on, boys. Let's get show on road.
Bum our life patrol.
What's the trouble here, boys?
They got an oral exciter.
Oral exciter?
Sounds like a job for Vice, Mark.
No, dudes.
Our Aphex oral exciter.
Uh-huh. Aphex oral exciter. What is it?
It's the zing in my strings, man.
The zap in my trap.
Makes my synthesizer wiser.
And my voice sound way choice.
But then they can't perform without it.
Hold on. Just the facts, boys.
Let me tell the dude.
Who are you?
The sound man, Jack.
The name's Marvin. So what is this Aphex thing, anyway?
The Aphex oral exciter type C is a patented analog psychoacoustic processor, which adds a natural openness, presence, and clarity to any audio signal by injecting dynamically expanded harmonic information.
Uh-huh.
Unlike an equalizer, the Aphex oral exciter has the unique ability to enhance or restore those portions of the audio spectrum, most often lost in the recording process or live performance environment.
Uh-huh. I think I'll talk to the band. What do you do with this Aphex thing, guys?
We use it for everything, dude. It's part of our sound.
Before we found the oral exciter, we were nowhere.
How's that?
Well, the group was way cool.
But something was missing.
Gretchen, this demo tape just doesn't have it. I can't sign these guys to the label. If Francis X and the Bushmen call, tell them I'm in a meeting. Permanently.
Sorry, boys. Got club to run here. You don't sound like headliner to me. Midnight show Monday. Best I can do. Take or leave.
We're the human beings. We're the ones that really matter now.
Just isn't making it, man.
It's losing it in the playback.
I don't get out of this studio soon, I go berserk.
You're the engineer. What do you think?
I think this session could use a little oral excitement.
All right.
Bring on the kinkettes.
Sounds good to me.
Where are my gloves?
Cool it, you animals. I'm not talking chicks. I'm talking Aphex, as in Aphex oral exciter.
Sounds way kinky to me, dude.
Hey, man, where do you hook it up?
Under the console, I'm sure.
Oh, man.
Get hip, guys. This thing's been used to mix and master thousands of hit albums. It makes the sound come alive.
Yeah? Well, show us.
Dig it. Let's start with the drums. Not bad, but listen to what happens with the Aphex oral exciter.
Hear that air in my snare. Listen to those cymbals sizzle.
Now the guitar. Now the guitar with the oral exciter.
Man, I hear that like I'm playing it now.
Check out the electric guitars. Processed with the Aphex oral exciter.
Sounds even more electric. Listen to that axe cut.
And when I cut out the Aphex, Dullsville.
Run my synthesizer tracks through it, man.
Cool. Without Aphex, now with Aphex.
Hot, man. Really hot.
You want to hear hot? Listen to what it does for vocals.
Trashed out punks on a midnight spree. A world that's
these are the vocal tracks without Aphex.
Oh, 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 oh.
And when we add some oral excitement,
stand the line, run wild in disguise. Oh, 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 oh.
Way real.
No more civilized toys of war.
Sounds so clear, I can't believe it.
Back door!
You've been singing in English all this time?
Funny, dude.
I've saved the best trick for last. I'll take the whole mix. And presto.
That's great!
That's incredible.
That's the magic of Aphex.
Way far cool.
You know, record companies have been spending over $1,000 an album just to add Aphex Oral Excitement. And now you can buy this new Aphex Type C Oral Exciter. It's less than $300.
Unglaublich. I mean, unbelievable.
This will work fantastic with my portable studio.
Hey, dude, will it work for a live sound?
Like a charm. Just plug it into the PA and watch the Aphex magic happen.
Sensation. Work next 5 weeks solid, okay?
What a hot demo. Francis X and the Bushmen is the best new band I've ever discovered. Gretchen, I need to sign these guys now before it's too late. Get me their manager, pronto.
So you see, dude, ever since we discovered Aphex, everyone's been discovering us.
Uh-huh. I understand. We'll do our best to recover the unit.
We've nabbed the culprit, Marv. Here's the stolen property. Safe and sounding better than ever.
Back in biz.
Wait for it. Thanks, dudes.
Rock and roll!
Nice job, Harv.
Thanks, Marv.
Where'd you collar him?
Found him in that sleazebag hotel around the corner. Funny thing, though.
How's that?
He had the thing hooked up to one of those, blow-up dolls.
Uh-huh.
The story you have just heard could be true. Only the sound has been changed by the Aphex Oral Exciter. Put the Aphex Oral Exciter on trial. Call the number on this disc for the name of the Aphex dealer nearest you. The results of that trial will amaze you.